Their conclusions created a controversy over the protection of wolves, but it was only the beginning. In 1998, after several more years of genetic analysis, they made an amazing discovery.
One of the really big surprises in our research, which we thought was a study of the gray wolf, is that that's not the wolf that's here at all. To everybody's surprise, the genetics results discovered that we really have been studying the red wolf, not the gray wolf. There's two species of wolves in the world. Both live in North America, the red wolf and the gray wolf. The red wolf was thought to live only, lived only in eastern North America, supposedly from about the southeast, from Virginia south to Florida. Gray wolves inhabited the rest of North America. But red wolves became extinct in the wild in about 1965 or 1970. There's only one wild red wolf population that was reintroduced at great expense by the U.S. government in North Carolina, some captive stock. So this looks like a species about to go out of existence. And to everybody's surprise, we suddenly find another population of it, and it's here in Algonquin Park.
The Thaberge's discovery of a rare wolf species, not even supposed to exist in Canada, was viewed with suspicion due to their controversial opinions about the declining wolf numbers in the park. Even Michael Runce wasn't convinced at first.
In the early years, we always wondered why the animals here were so small and more brightly colored. I've seen wolves in northern Ontario, and they're quite a bit different looking. They're bigger and more gray. And finally, when I began to really analyze what was being written about the red wolf situation and the DNA results, then I finally came to the conclusion that, yeah, that they're right, that these are red wolves.
Almost overnight, Algonquin Park had become a fortress for one of the world's rarest animals. But could even a park protect it?
Not many ways to get around the park apart from on foot or by canoe. But that's the beauty of the park. It's got this great network of lakes and rivers and streams, and you can paddle almost anywhere. Now, of course, there are some carry points, some portages to deal with, but they aren't that bad. And actually, it's kind of fun carrying an 80-pound canoe and your camera gear over a 2-kilometer portage. It's good for you.
Algonquin Park is laced with 1,600 kilometers of canoe routes, and Michael Runce has probably traveled on every one as a leading park naturalist and photographer. Wherever there's a beaver pond, it's a good bet you'll find wolves prowling for a snack. Of all animals other than the wolf, the beaver has the most powerful impact on this ecosystem. Throughout Algonquin, there are thousands of beaver ponds, which create habitats for a lot of other animals. The ponds, for example, support water plants, which are high in sodium and a favorite food of the moose. But with so many beavers around, without the wolf to regulate their population, Algonquin Park could become one gigantic beaver pond. And with the decline in the park's deer population, the beaver has become a major new food source for the declining wolf population. To study one of nature's most elusive animals, wolf scat has become an important research tool for John and Mary Thaberge.
There's two scats here.
Scat is another form of communication. To scientists, it tells a tale of current or changing eating habits. To wolves, animals who live in a world mapped out by scent, it marks their territory.
That one?
But this one's
older than the other one, and there's quite a bit of coarse hair in there. Could be the deer or moose.
Yeah, I don't see any beaver in it.
The other one looked like it could have some beaver. There it was, but this one seems far coarser than a beaver hair would be.
Yeah.
Well, there are no tracks on the road either, so.
Okay.
We collect about 1,000 scats a year, and from that we can analyze what the wolves are eating. Their diet consists of approximately one-third beaver, one-third moose, one-third deer. This has been different from the 1960s, where the diet was primarily 80% deer.
Wolves.